Hey everyone, Sam from Professional Music Technology here, and today we're taking a look at the Line 6 Pod Go Wireless. Now, I will say right off the bat, if you're here for a demo of the sounds and features of this unit, you are probably in the wrong place, but I will leave our in-depth review of the Pod Go linked up, so definitely go and check that one out. Instead, in this video, we're taking a look at its wireless capabilities, as this new version of the Pod Go, the Pod Go Wireless, comes supplied with a Line 6 Relay G10TII Mark II transmitter and a built-in digital receiver. If you've not seen one before, the Relay G10TII, this one's the Mark II version, is Line 6's high-quality yet affordable digital wireless transmitter that connects directly to your guitar's jack socket and gives you up to 7 hours of playing time on a single charge. It's compatible with a wide range of products, including the Line 6 Spider range of amplifiers, their Relay wireless guitar systems, the newer versions of the Yamaha THR amplifiers, and now, of course, the Pod Go Wireless. But in regards to the Pod Go, Line 6 have been a little bit vague when it comes to speccing out the performance of that wireless system. So I'm talking about things like range and how it deals with different environments and possible interferences. So in this video, we're going to be putting it through its paces. So our first little test is a pretty straightforward one, kind of simulating what it would be like to use the Pod Go Wireless either at home or maybe in a rehearsal studio. I've got the wireless transmitter connected to this Epiphone SG. The Pod Go's behind me there. I'm not really going to be more than kind of 2 or 3 meters away from it, and there's nothing in between the transmitter and the receiver that's going to cause any interference. As you can see, I do have a Boss Katana behind me as well. That's just so I can hear what's going on in the room. The audio that you're going to be hearing is coming directly from the Pod Go into our audio recorder. So I'm just going to play a couple of little riffs, a bit of clean, a bit of dirty, so we can see if there's any difference between using the wireless transmitter or connecting to the Pod Go via a standard guitar cable, which you can also do. Yeah, I don't know about you guys at home, but I can hear in the room a little bit of a difference in tone. The transmitter actually seems to be a little bit brighter and clearer, and there seems to be a little bit more volume there. But in terms of playability, there's no sort of latency or anything. It feels exactly the same. So I think we might need to take things up a notch. So for the next stage of our testing, I've taken the Pod Go Wireless out onto the shop floor here at PMT Portsmouth, and we're gonna kind of simulate what it might be like to use this in a live environment. So we've got lots of equipment around. We've got drum kits, amplifiers, lots of metalwork, and things that could interfere with the signal. So I'm gonna go for a little walk around the building and see if anything cuts out. Now, I will admit this bit's not exactly ideal. Meg's come along to help me out so she can stay by the amplifier and listen to it and tell me if it does cut out. But because I haven't got a GoPro or an action cam, I've kind of fashioned a selfie stick with a bike helmet and an old camcorder so you can follow me and see where I'm going. I'm not exactly sure how well this is going to work. Let's give it a go. Right, I think we are ready to give this a go. I've got the guitar connected to the amplifier via the wireless. All cameras are rolling. Meg's standing by to let me know if it cuts out. So let's go for a wander. So first up, I'm going to go down into our acoustic room. So let's go there quickly. So this is our acoustic room here. Let's go in and see if the walls make any difference to the signal. Oh, I'll tell you what, I've got that in my headphones coming through Meg's phone. It's really off-putting to try and play. But it is coming through loud and clear, isn't it, Meg?
It is coming through loud and clear.
Awesome. So that's with a wall between us. Let's go and see if a bit more distance makes a difference. So I'm going to walk past our big wall of Fender guitars. And that is taking me up to the back of the shop. So I can already hear that's coming through all right. Hello, Meg.
Hello.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to pop outside and see if that makes a difference, because the building we're in here has got some really thick concrete walls. So if I go outside, we'll see if it cuts out. So I'm in the entrance lobby. And I'm now going to pop through the door. Oh, great timing. Thank you very much. Right, I'm outside. Can you hear me, Meg?
I can hear you.
Right, let's see if you can hear the guitar.
Oh,
you can hear that, can't you? Briefly. I'm going to go a little bit further.
Yeah. And it's cutting out now.
That's cutting out, is it?
Yeah.
I think that's probably more to do with the walls as opposed to the distance. We will do a distance test in a moment, but yeah, I think if I come back in, yeah, the signal's going to come back really strong. So, back onto the shop floor. You should have the guitar again. So I'm now going to walk into our high-tech areas. So again, this is putting more kind of stud walls and metalwork in the way of the transmitter and the receiver. That seems to be coming through okay.
That's all good.
Awesome, right, let's go to the furthest point. So this is yet another wall in the way. I think we're all good, aren't we?
That's all good.
Spot on. So I'm really impressed with that, to be honest. I mean, that's further distances than you're going to have to kind of travel at most gigs. And you think about the amount of stuff that's in this room getting in the way. Yeah, that's really impressive. So, shall we go to the most extreme part of our test? So, for the final part of our test of the wireless capabilities of the PodGo Wireless, we're outside on the industrial estate outside PMT Portsmouth, and we're going for sheer distance. Let's see how far this thing can go. Right, so we are all connected up. You can hear me, can't you, Meg?
I can hear you.
We can hear the guitar. Let's go for a little wander and see how far I can get. Right, let's take a look at that. I'm no good at distances, but I'd say that's probably about 25 metres. It's coming through pretty clear, yeah?
It's coming through clear.
Let's go a bit further. Right, so that is probably about double the distance.
Yeah.
So, yeah, let's have a look. Is it still coming through?
It's coming through, all right.
I'm going to go a little bit further. We'll see when this cuts out. Right. Is that coming through?
That's still coming through.
Awesome, we'll go a little bit further. Right, I'm quite a long way now. Let's see if we've still got the signal. Loud and clear, right, okay. I mean, as I said, I'm no good with distances, but that is probably a good football pitch. So let's see if we can go a little bit further. Again, this is straight line. There's nothing actually in between the amplifier and, or the pod, shall I say, and the transmitter at the moment. Still got it.
Still got it.
Right. Now I'm getting close to the end of the industrial estate. Can you hear that?
Now that is cut out now.
That's cut out. Okay, I'm going to come back a bit further. I'm wondering if that's got anything to do with the fact that a van has just kind of cut the line aside. So I'm just going to cross the road.
coming through, isn't it?
Yeah, that's coming through.
Is it cutting out at all?
No, that's coming through clear.
Awesome. So I think, yeah, that was the line of sight then. We've now got another car moving in front. Let's see if that breaks it. Right, we're going to go a little bit further. I can feel it starting to rain, so we're going to have to be quick. Let's have a look. Still got it?
Still got it.
That's cut out, isn't it?
Yeah.
Awesome. I mean, I'm really impressed with that. That's a pretty long way. Definitely further than a football pitch length. So if you are ever going to play at Wembley Stadium, I think it's easily going to work for you. So yeah, for most kind of gigs and rehearsals and things like that, it's going to be perfectly adequate. Sounds great. We better get indoors, it's starting to rain.
And yeah, it did start raining quite heavily. So unfortunately, we didn't quite finish that test. But hopefully, despite the crudeness of those tests, it has given you an idea of how well the wireless system on the PodGo performs. For me personally, I've not used one of these Relay G10s before, and I was really impressed with it. As I mentioned earlier on in the video, there was a slight tonal difference between using a cable and the wireless transmitter, especially noticeable on the clean channels. But I actually preferred the tone of the wireless signal, as it seemed to be a little bit clearer with more presence. In terms of dropout, as you saw, regardless of where I went in the store or how many different walls or objects were in the way, we got a nice clear signal. It was only really when I went outside past those big thick concrete walls that we started to have a bit of a problem. And then latency wise, obviously it was a little bit difficult for me to tell at the time due to the speed of sound and what I was hearing depending on how far away I was. But when I came to tie up the audio files afterwards, so that's the audio from the camera that I had on me and then the audio that was coming out of the PodGo, there was no noticeable delay between what I was playing and what was coming out of the pod, regardless of the distance, which was really impressive, to be honest. So it's definitely going to be able to handle most live scenarios. So for more information on the PodGo Wireless or any of Line 6's relay products, visit pmtonline.co.uk or you can try one of these out for yourself at your nearest professional music technology store. As always, don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram as PMT House of Rock. If you enjoyed me wearing a silly hat, give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you again soon.